There. Okay. So. Hailing on all frequencies, this is a distress call from the bridge of the Dunwich Hauler. There's something on board our ship. Sensors can't detect it. Weapons are useless. They can't stop it. If we don't get to our escape pod soon, we're dead. It has slaughtered most of our crew and sabotaged our ship's systems. Please, help us. Oh my god. The captain's dead. It's just me stuck on this. I sealed off the command terminal. It's just me. Oh my god. Alright, I have to get some status reports. This is bridge to surgery. Come in,
bridge,
surgery.
Surgery's here. How are you doing?
Surgery, you sound awfully calm. I am covered in blood right now.
Oh, that's very normal for me. So I also am covered in blood. Bridge, I suggest you calm down a bit.
Sir, I
old friend, everything will be fine if we just keep our heads and work together collectively.
We've been friends forever. Just
we have been
since even before Starfleet Academy. Even
it's true. Even before Starfleet Academy,
we grew up on the same moon, the same station.
Galaxian Station.
How are you so calm?
What's over the moon of Saturn?
Where are you? Where are you right now? What are you doing?
I'm sealed in the surgery bay right now. Unfortunately, there are some things going on around me. I don't want to go into too much detail.
What do you mean? I'm doing a status report. I see some other blinking lights. It looks like we might have some other survivors. But tell me real quick, what's going on?
We'll get to that. I prefer to talk to a specialist in this matter, Bridge. Listen, I've got some paperwork I need to shuffle around real quick. Maybe figure out if anyone else is alive. Let me know.
You're acting so strange. Okay, Bridge out. Thank you, Surgery.
Surgery out.
What the hell is wrong with this guy? He's my friend and he's acting so weird. Let's check on Cryo. Bridge, Cryo.
Cryo here. Cryo here. Bridge, are you alive?
Well, I am. The captain is dead. I don't know. I'm trying to be brave here. But we can pull through here. Damn it! Can you give me a status report, Cryo?
Well, I think I'm stuck in the hypersleep chamber. Something's been here. All of the pods have been destroyed. I hope they were empty, but I can't tell. There's just crud everywhere. There's just stuff. It's not.
Have you tried manually overriding the cryopods, the hypersleep pods?
It's pointless. They're shattered. There's gunk everywhere. I just hope it's not who is supposed to be in them.
Oh my god.
Oh. Look.
Man.
It's not good to hear that the captain is dead, but
listen.
You're a good person, Bridge. You've always stuck to the letter of the rules, and if I had to have only one person commanding right now, I'm glad it's you.
God. Look. Cryo, put yourself together, man. We're gonna get through this. We're gonna get through this together.
Yeah, maybe.
Find some oxygen tanks. Don't breathe in whatever that gunk is. It's probably not good.
You're right. I should probably get something in me. I'll just step away for a moment and do that. Find out who else is alive.
Yes. All right. Cryo, hang in there. Bridge out. Oh my god. All right, we got one more light. So there must be at least another survivor. Bridge, this is Bridge to medical. Anyone down there?
You got medical.
Oh, medical. Oh, thank God you're here. Listen, the captain's dead. I've sealed myself off into the command terminal. Oh, there's a lot of blood, man. What's going on?
Well, I'm trapped in the sick bay. The door systems are offline. The rest of the medical staff is dead. I just woke up. It's gonna take me a bit to get my bearings here.
Alright, well, and look around. I mean, what's give me a status report. Who's with you? Anybody?
Well, there's the chief medical officer. He's dead. There's the junior medical officer. He's dead. It's just me.
Oh my god. All right, what's All right, can you do you see where the escape pods are? Do you have a ship schematic?
Not one I can access from sickbay.
Damn it. Okay. From up here I can see there's a couple escape pods here, but you said you're trapped?
Yes, the door systems are offline.
Ah, the door system. Okay. We might have to override the power over here. Let me see if I can get someone to help you here. Hang on there, medical. Bridge out. And who can I trust? Who can I trust to help him right now? I want to rely on my best friend, but he's so calm. I don't like it. Going with my gut here. Bridge to surgery. Come in.
Surgery here.
Oh my god. You know, your voice is so nice in these trying times. Hey,
thanks, listen, old buddy.
Listen, medical needs some help.
Can you patch me through to medical then? I also have a problem I need medical to solve, so you can drop off the line while we're talking.
Copy that. All right, bridge connecting to medical, bridge out.
Medical, surgery here.
Oh, surgery. Thank God it's you.
What is the status? I don't recognize this crew member. Where is the chief medical officer?
He is very much eviscerated.
Medical officer?
Also dead. He's,
as the head of surgery, that makes me the new chief medical officer. And medical, I'm gonna need some help here. There is a parasite growing inside me. I can hear its thoughts. It wants to eat me. It's very important that I get some outside assistance.
Yeah, let me see what I can do here.
Is there something I can help you with in the process? I am attempting to maintain total calm. However, I want to reiterate, medical, it is constantly sending me thoughts of how it is going to eat me. I believe, based on the current thought images it's sending me, that it is approaching my liver.
Ah, I see. That
As
sounds
you know,
very
medical. That's a very vital organ. Yes.
I know a few things about my liver. Let me tell you. I can help you out, surgery. I'll get you out of this. Let me teletransmit a biochemical droid to your location.
Teletransmit. Okay. Is there something I can help you in the process? I know that takes a while, like a minute or two to teletransmit.
Yeah. So there are tumors growing under my skin.
That sounds very bad.
But they're moving.
That also sounds very bad.
Yes, I know. I just discovered them. You gotta help me out, man.
I have.
You're a surgeon, right?
Let me offer you some advice. I can energize the remote prognosis terminal and link it to your mobile metastation.
All right. That sounds good. There's a terminal right here. I can access the mobile metastation.
All right. I'm currently charging up the remote prognosis terminal. It's going to take a minute.
All right. The biochemical droid should be there.
All right. I am allowing it to do its work. Can you report on its progress? I can still hear the sentient parasite in my brain. It does appear to have consumed one quarter of my liver. The pain is intense right now.
That's fine. You only need half a liver. We got plenty of time.
As the head of surgery, I happen to know that that's a lie, medical. I happen to know.
Look, I just read what the scanner says, man. All right. The biochemical droid's just about finished. You should be fine.
Okay. I no longer hear voices in my head. That's good. Unfortunately...
What about my arm? There's growth.
I know, there's been a problem. The remote prognosis terminal is not charging up.
What do you mean there's been a... You can't help me. There's tumors in my arm.
I'm trying to help you, but the remote prognosis terminal... I'm getting a lockout. Apparently, it's not accepting my authorization code. As a medical officer. Medical, give me a couple minutes. I'll try to see if I can come back with another solution to your problem.
All right. I'm glad I could help you, surgery.
All right, surgery out.
Medical out.
Okay, it looks like they're done talking. Oh my god. All right. Well, I hope I don't know what's going on over there. I keep hearing random noises, like my communications on the fritz. I better check in with Cryo before I lose them. Bridge to Cryo. Come in, Cryo.
Cryo here.
How you doing in there, man? Talk to me.
Not good, Bridge. I've got access to a lot of systems down here. A lot of stuff's down the fritz, but I don't know how helpful I'm gonna be. I got some bleeding, Bridge.
Oh no.
I had some internal bleeding, but it's quickly becoming external bleeding.
Oh crap. Okay. Do you need surgery or medical? I don't know. They seem to be both good. Who do you need, Cryo? I can patch you through.
You don't happen to have access to anything up where you are?
No, I'm stuck in this command station.
Oh, I don't want to. All right. You know what? Under these circumstances, surgery. Get me surgery.
Copy that, Cryo.
Cryo out.
Bridge to surgery. Come in, surgery. Here. Surgery. How you doing?
Well, I did have a psychic parasite eating my liver, but I'm doing much better now. I do have a slight problem I was hoping you might be able to take care of.
Maybe, but right now, I really need your help with Cryo. I'm gonna patch
Understood.
You through Cryo, okay? Okay. Bridge, Cryo, patched here. In.
Surgery, this is Cryo. I've got some internal bleeding that turned into external bleeding.
That sounds very bad.
I've got access to a lot of systems down here, but I don't think I can operate them in my current condition. Can you help me out?
I can. I think that there's something you can help me with, Cryo, and I know that you have things that are going on with you. Let me just throw this at you, and we can work on our problems together.
Yeah, no, that sounds like I'll do my best.
I'm starting up my project now, and as soon as I confirm that it will work, I'll get it to you.
Yeah.
I have a sentient biotoxin outside the exam room. It is writing on the walls in Klingon that it wants to get in here and take over my body. It is forming different shapes. It moves from dodecahedron into a cube. Occasionally it will grow a vestigial limb in order to write in biotoxin slime.
Yeah.
I don't suppose there's anything you can do to deal with that. I'm fairly certain if it gets in here, I'm super duper dead.
Yeah, no, I got something for that. Look, the whole ship, the nanite containment pods have burst, surgery. The whole ship is flooded with nanites. If I isolate the wavelength in the nanite resonator, I can destroy all biomass outside the thing. Don't you worry, the thing that is sentient, it'll just dissolve into the carbons and proteins.
That sounds perfect, Cryo.
It works.
I've just confirmed that the biofiltration network is online. If I overload it, it should begin, the nanites in your room will begin to reverse the internal bleeding that you have.
All right, let me get started on the nanite.
I'm also starting on mine, as long as I need your verbal consent to allow this to happen.
Yeah, no, I give consent for you to do that.
Excellent.
To
Thank
me.
You very much. All right, I've begun the biofiltration network overload. I haven't asked recently. I know we're in a bit of a situation, but it's no reason not to be polite. How are your kids doing?
I mean, Molly just sent a picture through the hyperspace network, and you know, she's really into art.
What's she now? 16, 17?
Yeah, no, she's really into that like three-dimensional quantum stuff where I can't tell.
I never could get into that, but yeah, I have a cousin who does that kind of work.
Yeah, she's in a gallery and stuff. Sam Sam doesn't know what he's doing with his life. I wanted him to join Starfleet like his old man, but after something like this, I don't know.
Cryo, I have good news. It looks like the biofiltration network overload is successful. Unfortunately, the biofiltration network never going to work again. The ship is a garbage scow now. But be seeing signs that your external bleeding is tapering off.
Yeah, no, I feel better already. I feel less lightheaded. I've got equally good news for you, Surgery. I've isolated the wavelength for outside your room. That sentient biomass should be dissolving in front of your eyes.
I see it. Thank you so much, Cryo. Really, when this is all over and we're in the escape pod, we should probably sit down and have a cup of coffee and talk about maybe setting our kids up on a date sometime.
That's a little forward in this situation, Surgery, but,
it's going to be days until Starfleet shows up to save us, so might as well just take some time to plan. Anyway, unless you got anything else...
No, this is Cryo out.
Okay, this is Bridge. Bridge to medical. Come in, medical.
Bridge, I need help with an emergency.
You hear those alarms? You hear those alarms?
Yes.
Alright, sound like it's coming from the reactor. It looks like it might be running out of power. What's up? What can we do?
The plant life in the hydroponic garden has made its way into the sick bay. It's mobile and it's trying to kill me.
Seal yourself off. Are there any shovels? Any guns?
I have a flashlight. And all I have is a flashlight, Bridge.
Don't use the flashlight. Don't turn it on. Whatever you do, turn it on. They're photosynthetic. They're photosynthetic. They'll cut the lights. Kill the power. You might cry yourself some time.
Patch me to cryo.
Copy that. Bridge to cryo. Come in, cryo.
Yes, Bridge. I'm feeling much better.
Excellent.
Much better.
Listen, there is some very, 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 very hungry horticulture going on in medical.
That is a thing.
And we are running low on power. What can we do?
Well, pass me through to medical.
I did. You're on. Medical, are you there?
So Cryo, do you read me?
Yeah, this is Cryo.
There's a sentient plant trying to kill me. Get back!
Look, okay, look. I can synthesize something in the organic centrifuge. I can
just do it!
No, but, all right. Look, I can get that started, but it's going to take some time, medical.
All right!
While I'm doing that, I know you're dying, but could you perhaps... Look... I've got a problem here.
What could you possibly need at a time like this?
Well, there's something in the cargo hold. It sounds really huge and pissed, and it's trying to get through the wall into the hypersleep chamber.
All right.
You have access to certain things. You're near cargo. Could you take care of it?
There's a terminal here. I could boost the nerve node from here. Maybe. That could accelerate the cargo hold and keep it contained.
That's a great idea. All right, I'm working on the org. I accept
just,
that offer of
just
help.
Just keep me covered.
I'm going to do the organic centrifuge thing.
Get up. It's just a plant.
Well, many things are just plants.
But it's a big plant.
And it's attacking you.
Yes.
Look, I'm trying to synthesize something to kill it.
Hurry, please.
All right, I've got some bad news, medical.
What?
I tried to synthesize something to kill the giant plant that's killing you, but it's mostly made out of human DNA.
Oh, God!
I don't know why, but I couldn't kill it. The immune system fought it off. I'm sorry, medical.
I've got some bad news for you, too.
Oh,
the nerve node shorted. That thing's still in the cargo hold, and it's coming closer. I'm sorry, Cryo!
I'm sorry, medical. Maybe we can try something else in a little bit. Just hide under a desk.
Alright, I'm hiding. Medical out.
Cryo to Bridge.
This is Bridge. Come in, Cryo.
Me and medical still have a lot of problems that aren't solved.
My God. Well, we have to in order to get to the escape pods. What do you need? Give me your status report. What's going on?
I've got something in the cargo hold. It's trying to get through the wall.
Is it breathing?
It's big, and
there's a wall and it's trying to get through it. That's all I know, Bridge.
Okay, because I keep hearing this breathing and it's really heavy and it's freaking me out. I want to know if you have to... Okay. Okay, that's fine.
I mean, that could be me. I'm pretty tight here in my cryopod where I'm hiding.
Okay. Well, okay. 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 I'll get you something. Do you think surgery could help you?
I don't know if surgery can help with this one. Maybe look, medical still has a problem. Patch medical through to surgery and maybe they once medical isn't dying, he can help me with my problem.
Affirmative, Cryo. Bridge out. This is Bridge. Bridge to medical. Come in, medical.
I'm here.
Bridge, how are you holding up with that plant, my friend?
It's docile for now, but I keep beating it when it comes close.
Do you remember our mission to Zordon 2? Do you remember that?
Yes, yeah. I remember.
Sing it songs. Remember, the weird plants like songs.
What?
Sing, goddammit, sing for your life.
The plant monster? No.
Sing for your life.
Surgery.
God. All right, I'm connecting you with surgery.
Surgery here.
Surgery! There's a plant monster in the sick bay, and it's attacking me!
You know, I happen to have just the thing to help you. Did you know that organic matter, like plants, are made up almost entirely of alkaloids?
Uh-huh, it's very intriguing!
Yes. Apparently, alkaloids have very important effects on the nitrogen atoms within their bodies. I might be able to reverse the signal transmitter on the alkaloid transmission in your medical bay.
I don't understand it, but go for it.
It will cause the plant to break apart and die in a manner that is horrific. Is this plant a sentient creature?
I don't know. It's the plant life from the hydroponic garden. It's morphed into a mass.
Medical, can you confirm that the medical marijuana that we were shipping is now itself a sentient plant life?
Yes, it is.
You are recording all this data for transmission later, right?
Stop.
All right, I've begun reversing the signal. It's gonna take about 2 minutes for the effects to make themselves known. While I've got you on the line, I just need to ask, why are you such a pathetic quivering worm?
What?
You're aware that no one likes you on this ship, right? People are waiting for you to die.
There's a plant monster about to kill me. I'm quivering.
I'm best to save you, but you know that the reason you're the lowest ranked medical officer on the ship is because not only does no one like you on the ship, but no one back home likes you either.
What? Surgery. Come on. You're my only friend.
It's nice of you to say that.
I always thought of you kindly.
Yep. I mean, that's good. I'm trying to help you out here. You realize that as your new position, you are technically the junior medical officer of a starship. That's going to look really good on a resume, but you're going to have to work on being such a coward.
Yeah, if I get out of here, I'll update my resume.
Yeah, it's unbecoming of a Starfleet officer. You know I'm going to have to note this conversation in the log, right?
Yes, note it in the log.
Okay, all right. I have bad news. The signal reversing on the alkaloid transmitter did not work. The plant is actually 25% more physically stronger and more dexterous.
Oh, God.
I believe the medical marijuana symbiont sentient being is now at the height of its evolutionary power.
Why? Why did you do that?
I tried to do my best here, okay? This is new science. I know it seems like I'm very calm right now, but I do want to point out I had a parasite eating my liver, describing the delicious...
Yeah, and I helped you with that, and you didn't help me with this!
I'm trying to help you with it right now.
Alright, I'm turning the flashlight on.
Listen, I have two suggestions for you, medical. I believe you need to talk to Bridge, and second, just reach inside yourself, find that cowardice and you know, the way that you relate to a gutless worm and remove it from your body as quickly as possible.
Yeah, that's really great advice. It'll surely help me kill this plant monster.
I mean, worms eat plants. And you are one, so good luck.
Would you? Medical out!
Bridge, this is Bridge to Medical. Looks like surgery cut out. Are you okay?
Yeah, no, I'm definitely not okay. It didn't work. The plant monster is more powerful. The tumors have continued to spread. My entire arm,
look,
my left arm, I've lost control of it.
You're not getting out. You're not dying on my watch. You're not dying on my watch, Medical. Use that flashlight.
You told me not to turn it on, but I did.
Oh, God. It's okay. It's okay. We can still get through this. We can still get... Listen, do you trust me? Medical, do you trust me?
Yes, Bridge, I trust you. Even good. Though you're a weakling, I trust you.
That's completely fine. Okay, listen to me. This is what we need to do. We have a very, very, very short amount of time. Okay, do you remember what Cryo said a little bit ago?
No, I've been focused on the plant thing. What?
Damn it! I was really hoping you remember because I forgot. Okay, I have to patch you through the cryo. Okay, I'm patching you the cryo. Bridges, is cryo? Come in.
Cryo,
I'm patching you the medical.
No. You know what? I need to talk to surgery.
What? Cryo.
There's no time. Talk to medical.
I know there's no time. We're all gonna die. I have something to say to surgery before we die.
Cryo, stop acting so weird. No, you must talk to medical.
No, I demand to speak to surgery.
Cryo, the plant monster's getting bigger.
Hide under a desk, medical.
I'm under the desk. It found me. Cryo, come on. You gotta do something, man.
Bridge, patch me through to surgery. It'll only take a second.
All right, fine. But hang on,
I'll
medical.
Fine.
Hang on.
Fine. Medical out.
Cryo, this is Bridge. Do we still have a connection? I got the power lights in the red here, man. Do we still have a connection?
You still have a connection with me. You need to patch me through to surgery.
Copy that. I'll patch you through to surgery. Bridge, this is surgery.
Bridge, this is surgery. Yes.
This is Bridge surgery.
Are you okay there, old friend?
I'm sorry. I'm freaking out. There's blood. I can't hear anything. Hello?
You know,
hello?
It's strange. Why haven't you come to me with your problems yet, friend?
I am completely locked in here.
You don't have anything you need help with?
No, I... Listen, I'm... Crew first, then myself.
I understand.
Listen, I'm patching you through to Cryo.
All right. Cryo, this is surgery.
Surgery, this is Cryo. I know you said that if we got out of here alive, we'd be hooking our kids up and stuff.
Well, I thought a date would be nice between them, you know. I know that we've often said...
Look, surgery, there's no time. Surgery, I watched you do it. I saw you freak. Show me what you did.
I did it. I confess. I didn't think you were there when I did it, but those prisoners stood in the way of Starfleet's medical advancement. I saw their dossiers when we picked them off of Halcyon 4. Their research into the genetic material of humans was unethical. It couldn't be allowed to spread.
You can't just appoint yourself judge, jury, and executioner. We have laws.
But there's something you don't know, Cryo. I'm above those laws. I'm part of Section 31.
Not Section 31. Section 31 is a myth.
It's real. It's very real.
I don't.
And now that I've told you, there's only two choices for you. Either you're going to have to join us, or you're going to have to die.
Well, this thing in the cargo hold might do that job for you.
I wish I could help you. Unfortunately, I've exhausted all my options here. I'm actually packing.
I just wanted you to admit to that execution.
Oh, okay. Is there anything I should bring for you in case you make it to the escape pod? I'm packing a bag real quick. I got plenty of snacks. Toblerone? Do you have a preference? I mean, the refrigerator is down, so...
Yeah, you can bring a phaser surgery. So I can shoot myself rather than take the entire journey back to Earth with you. Sir Cryo out! Bridge, get me medical. Bridge. Medical needs my help.
Surgery out.
I'm coming. Say again, Cryo. Who do you need?
I need medical so I can save his life.
Copy that. This is Bridge. Bridge to medical.
I broke the flashlight. I hit it too hard against the alien. The plant thing. It's not an alien. It was born from the plants.
Oh, God. Oh, it's all coming back to me. No, stay strong. Stay strong. Listen, medical, I have to pass you through this to cryo.
Okay. Cryo, are you there? This is medical.
Yeah, medical. This is cryo.
Do you have anything that can help me?
Yes. Yes, I can optimize the signal in the cortical transducer. That should be in medical bay.
And yes, it's in the corner right there, the cortical transducer.
Yeah, it'll shoot like a crazy sci-fi beam at the thing. It'll kill it.
All right.
But I need to know if you have anything else for me. The creature's still in the cargo hold.
Well, I can access the brain frame and modify an artificial protein relay that could dissolve the creature in theory.
We had a lot of success with dissolving things.
Yeah, I mean, you tried to dissolve something and you just made a human arm come out of the replicator.
Look, I'm gonna get started on optimizing the signal in the cortical crans.
All right, I have my terminal here. I'll access the brain frame. Please hurry, Cryo.
I'm going as fast as I can.
We're gonna get out of this. We won't die here. Not until I see that bastard in surgery.
Yeah, I don't like him either.
Cryo?
Yeah.
This might be a personal question, but do you like me?
You've always treated me badly, medical.
I treat everyone like that.
You've always treated me like dog shit. You're one of the worst people on this ship, medical.
What?
And that's why I don't feel bad when I say that the cortical transducer didn't work.
What?
You're gonna die, medical.
No.
Everyone's glad. Everyone's glad, medical.
I was able to dissolve the thing in the cargo hold.
Thank you for saving my life. It's the only thing your life's ever been good for.
I'm sorry, Cryo. I should have been a better friend to you, a better officer. Should have,
but I'll make sure that they remember you as a good person instead of the scumbag that you are.
Bridge, this is medical. I've exhausted all my options. I've lost full control of my left arm to the tumors. The plant is enveloping my right.
Look at me. It's okay. No, listen to me. Medical, stay strong. It's okay.
It's too late for me, Bridge. Get yourself to the pods. Medical out.
No, I need to ask you. And as you like, get sucked away. No, he's sucked away. He's gone. Bridge, this is Bridge of Surgery. Come in, Surgery.
Old buddy. Here. How's it going, old friend?
How's it going? Can I count on you?
I'm out of solutions here, and honestly, even if I had one, listen, we're good friends, but I would have used any options I had available on anyone else before I did you. I just need to tell you, ever since we've been kids, you've just been such a huge coward. I don't know why you didn't come to me first. You were so afraid of failure that you were willing to watch as the power bars in your office continued to climb down, hoping for a dramatic rescue, but it doesn't look like we're coming.
God.
I've got nothing I can do to help you, bud.
God damn it, man. Well, then at least hear me out.
I will hear you out, sure. Do you mind if I drink a Gatorade?
Screw you, Surgery. Screw you and your screwy face. You screw.
Those are some profound words.
You'll never amount to anything in your life. You're so mean. You've always been a jerk. You've always will be a jerk. Here I thought I could count on you. We just lost medical. Medical is dead. God
I
damn it.
I asked you repeatedly, Bridge, if you wanted my help and you blew me off. I had to do the problems that you assigned to me.
All I wanted to do was confess to you something and I can't because you're a jerk.
Confess it to me now. It's okay.
No. What's the point? It doesn't matter anymore.
I need to listen.
Who cares about what the captain did?
Your mom.
What I saw.
I care. first off, because I need to put it in the log as a chief medical officer. And I think I might be the highest ranked person on the ship. But second, I need something to tell your mom, because our moms get along very well. And I'd really hate, you know, for me to go to your mom and say, I don't have any last words for you. So listen, just calm down. It's fine that, you know, that this is happening. You signed up for this. You signed up for this when we went into Deep Space Exploration. I told you when we got on the Dunwich Hauler that we would see some dangerous missions, but it's all right, buddy. Tell me what you think. Tell me what you saw the captain do, and tell me what you would like me to tell your mom and everyone. I'll do my best to make sure that you're remembered as a hero at your memorial rather than just the gutless spine we know you are.
I'll tell my parents myself. Bridge out. Bridge, this is Cryo. Come in, Cryo.
This is Cryo. I'm here.
Hey, how's it going, man? Can I get a status report? Status report?
I'm out of solutions.
You're out of solutions?
I got nothing else that I can do for anybody. Everybody else on the ship is doomed.
Listen, surgery is complete. We lost medical. Surgery is a complete jerk. I can't trust him. Listen, I need to tell you something.
Bridge, I know. Don't you worry. He's trying to seduce me and fraternize with my children, but he's a murderer and a scumbag and a traitor as far as I'm concerned. When I make it to that escape pod, why, I'm gonna kill him. I'm gonna kill him if he's on my escape pod, and if he's in a different escape pod, I'm gonna crash my escape pod into his escape pod. Somebody like that shouldn't make it back out alive. Not when people like you, Bridge. Not when people like you are sacrificing their lives to save the others.
Listen, I don't know. I'm trying to get out of here. I'm trying to do everything I can here, but it doesn't look like I can get out.
You're a good man, Bridge. You're a much better man than surgery or medical, and I'm glad medical's dead.
I'm not a brave man. The things I saw, the things that I kept from everyone, I saw what the captain did on the surface of Zexon 12. I saw what he smoked and what he brought on board the ship and left in
the
horticultural room.
Dead. Maybe the only person who deserves to get out alive is me, since I haven't done anything shitty. Except for that I'm going to murder surgery as soon as I can. Well, Bridge?
If I can't have your forgiveness, then I'll just have to have death.
It was an honor serving with you, Bridge.
It's an honor.
I'm going to take this piece of jagged glass from one of these broken cryo chambers, and I'm going to hunt surgery down. Cryo out.
Right. Bridge, is this surgery? Your solution's been used?
Bridge, you've mislabeled yourself again. You're Bridge, I'm surgery. Surgery here.
Freaking out, man. I'm sorry.
It's all right, buddy.
I'm ready.
I still have this Gatorade here. I'm drinking it. I'll stop if you have some confessions you want to make.
I'm super low on air here.
All right, just tell me what you want me to tell your mom. It's very clear to me that you're not going to make it out of this alive.
Nothing.
Okay, I won't tell your mom anything. Just want to let you know, I've resolved all the problems outside of my area. I am currently bringing a Toblerone for my good friend Cryo to the only escape pod left on the ship. I've also got a phaser set to stun that should help me get past the mysterious monster currently rampaging. I hope you're doing okay, Bridge. It's a good day to die when you know the reason why, and just remember, the Federation in Section 31 thanks you for your sacrifices.
Alright,
I'm out. Have a good day. Just final note, as a medical officer, I want to tell you, you don't have to worry about not having oxygen. You're definitely going to freeze to death before you lose air.
Then I'll deliver my own last words.
Surgery out, old buddy.
The Dunwich Hauler, where I thought would be a stepping stone to a new proud career as a Starfleet officer, has now become a tombstone in my own life. I'm not letting the monster get to me. not going to let him get me. I'm going to take my own life beforehand. Go! Go!
All right. I like to think that in the end, someone ate a Toblerone.
Yeah, surgery by himself.
We're done, right?
Yeah, we're done.
Done.
We're done. I'm taking a piece of glass to the escape pod outro. Chat, let's take time to press F to pay respects to both medical and Bridge. They did a very good job of begging for help and not getting it.
Yeah, well, my job... here's what I had to do, right? The only way I can survive this game is if I'm forgiven by one of the characters who's not going to make it. And both of you fuckers are going to make it. And medical got killed.
Is that really what it is?
Yeah, this is how I survive. I survive.
The only way to survive. You know, you still have to resolve. Do you not have emergencies you need to resolve?
No, I don't. This is my emergency. My emergency is that I saw the captain do something heinous, and I have to confess, and I have to have forgiveness. And I can only get forgiveness by someone who's going to die.
Wow. That's why you were desperate to talk to medical then.
Yeah.
Failure after failure.
You guys both fucking threw medical under the bus and then got away, and I couldn't do anything.
I don't know if you noticed, but my sheet only has one success on it. And I was banking on the fact that
I had two success, one failure.
Fuck.
I was banking on the fact that Wreckage would give me a success so that I would get out of the situation and I'd be like, cool, wink.
Yeah, no, I'm
sorry, Cyfry, I put my faith in Wreckage, not you.
I was playing it up. It says you're supposed to, which is basically like pay attention to who's presented a failure and a success, right? So like, I basically was like, he's already got two failures. He's got to have a success. I'll take that from him.
Guys.
The reason when Arthur betrayed me with the failure, it says on my sheet that surgery is the only one you admire.
I know. So can we take a minute to read all of our sheets?
Yeah. Sure. Let's go around. I'll start.
I don't stroke out.
Okay. Yeah, that's fair. So I was playing Bridge. I am a hero. I am a serious and brave ranking officer. I'm trapped in the command terminal. Medical has always questioned your authority, and surgery is your best friend who always takes your side. Then I'm supposed to have come up with something that the captain did or saw that was unforgivable. And then I'm supposed to just frame scenes for you guys. And then the only way I can survive, I can't offer solutions to anybody in this round. But the only way I can survive is if I'm forgiven by one of the characters who isn't going to make it. I have to confess to them about what the captain did and then ask for their forgiveness. Instead, my escape... If I'm unable to do that, then my escape pod is blocked and I'm trapped on the ship.
It's a good day to die.
Yeah, you guys did... that was really good. Who wants to go next?
I'll go next. So I was playing medical. You're a survivor, hostile and bitter chief medical officer, trapped in the sick bay. Bridge is weak and ineffectual, and surgery is the only one you admire. And I had a secret that I was supposed to reveal after someone solved one of my emergencies, but nobody did that.
Can you tell us what the secret is?
The secret is, it says you conducted a prohibited medical experiment. No one knows about it, but after one of your emergency gets solved, you have a crisis of conscience.
You made the marijuana monster.
I did it. It was me.
Are we calling this one Reefer Madness or something? Are we calling? I mean, not. We can't call it Reefer. It's got to have like a good space pun in that too. But it's definitely there. Space Reefer.
I would call it Dirge for the Dunwich Holler. But
all right.
So what did you decide that your medical thing was? Because you decide before you when you.
I didn't decide I was going to make it up on the spot, but I like the idea that I made the plant monster.
It's your own comeuppance.
Yeah. Why was fools to play God? Oh my God! What a like fun short game.
This is a lot of fun,
guys. I'm gonna play the shit out of this game.
No, I was halfway through where got I it.
Little Ship of Horrors. Fuck. That's so good.
Great job, Sith Master. Swish.
Great job. Fucking nailed it.
Wreckage, you nailed it, man. Are you reading your character next?
The plant monster comes out of medbay. Feed me, Seymour.
So I was Cryo, and I'm doomed, which kind of sucks. Frantic but wily cryogenics technician. You're stuck in the hypersleep chamber. Bridge is a good person, though maybe a little straight-laced. Medical has always treated you badly. My emergencies were that I was injured with internal bleeding, and that there was something in the next chamber, huge and blah, blah, blah. My solutions were the cortical transducer, which is a failure, the nanite resonator, which is a success, and synthesize something in the organic centrifuge, which is a failure. So I had two failures and a success. And I had the secret of I saw surgery do something awful before everything went wrong. And once I've used two of my solutions, I'm supposed to ask Bridge to contact surgery for me, and then say, surgery, I watched you do it. I saw you, you freak, which triggers him explaining his secret.
I'm surgery. My character sheet opens with the words, they're all gullible idiots. I am charismatic and sociopathic head of surgery. I'm stuck in the exam room. Bridge thinks we're friends, but you despise his cowardly swineliness. Medical is a quivering worm, and you can't wait to say so. My solutions were failure, failure, success. And when my original line for surgery, I watched you do it, was to establish that we were in the Warhammer 40K universe by talking about the Emperor's gene mods. And when someone had already talked about Starfleet, I was like, what was that thing from Deep Space Nine, Section 31? I'm probably part of that. And I just murdered a bunch of prisoners. You know, extra legal stuff. I wanted to say...
Why is charismatic sociopath the perfect character for Arthur?
I mean, remember when I opened the PDF, right? I immediately started laughing.
Yeah,
I remember that.
I want to say, thank you, Eric, for setting this up. I know we had talked about it. I had looked for a game that could only be played online, and this was the first thing that showed up when I searched for it. And I shared it with everybody, and I was like, this looks cool. Because I'm preparing for when Inheritance, the Luke Crane LARP, comes out next year to try to do that. But I also have a game of this that's going down on the 16th, if you want to come watch that. Wreckage is in it as well. We're probably going to do two or three episodes in a row. Maybe we might be wizards at one point. There's a lot of different things you can do with this.
Yeah.
There are.
I want to really thank Sci-Fry, by the way, for just getting murdered really, really badly.
Really well.
Here's the thing. Like halfway through, I remembered that Scream was in the title. And I'm like, I should be screaming.
Yeah, no, Sci-Fry died with chutzpah.
With chutzpah.
I know. You slowly broke down. I want to also say how much I appreciate Eric. When I was like, hi, surgery here, everything's fine. How you're like, God, that's so weird. And I'm like, yes, I am weird.
See, based on what you were playing, I thought that was the parasite doing that to you, and you're my friend deep down. And no, it was you the whole time.
You're just a horrible person from the beginning.
I thought that your parasite was making you a sociopath.
This game. It's just like a short, controlled burst of good storytelling.
1, 2, 3, 4, yeah, 5, really 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11. There's like 12, 13, 14. There's like 15 different scenarios to choose from, guys.
Plus, there's everything from ViewScream First Edition. Only has a little bit of overlap with ViewScreen 2.
Yeah, so definitely going. Yeah, I think MVP goes to as much as I love MVP,
best actor,
Sci-Fry with the fucking flashlight. Man.
I gotta say, best props goes to Wreckage for the blinking camera lights. Like, you got deep in on it.
Oh God,
yeah, everything was awesome. Blinking over here. I only seized a little bit.
I'm a little scared that everyone seems to think that I play a good sociopath. That's starting to get a little worrisome.
Well, you're like a charismatic sociopath.
Right.
I mean, you're making it sound better by putting charismatic in front of sociopath. A little worried. Remember how we were talking about character typing before the show? I'm worried that my character, like, when we character type Wreckage as a doctor, it's because he calls himself doctor, but also because he's intelligent, smart person. I'm worried that people are typing me as a sociopath because they think I'm a sociopath.
Look, it's just because you play an excellent sociopath. You're like Anthony Hopkins. He can't play anything else now.
Didn't he play Thor's dad in Thor?
Yeah, but everyone was like, fantastic. When's he gonna eat somebody's face? Like, so, well, that's what I was thinking when I was watching Thor.
Yeah. So this is a lot of fun. There's almost like, never mind. I can't say.
No, say it. Say it. You literally can't back out of
no
it.
Regrets.
No regrets.
No regrets. No ragrats, right?
No rugrats.
No rugrats. I heard a really great idea for a game from TwitchCon. That's basically, this game came up as ViewScream as like a, hey, this game does a lot of what we're doing. You know, like, we're all trapped in different rooms and, you know, we all have to help each other and there's a betrayal mechanic, right? Mm-hmm. Now imagine this part. Add this part to the game. So this is a VR thing. Your solutions and problems are now like, keep talking and nobody explodes.
Oh, yeah.
Like, you're in, like, a VR space, so you have to, like, walk them through the solutions to get out.
That could work.
All right, I'm listening to the Morse code now. ..
Was it a dot?
I don't know. I'm falling behind. Okay, give me a couple seconds.
Yeah, keep talking and everybody explodes is a game for people that have perfectly functioning synapses in their brain, which is not people.
Most people
are going to get stuck on, like, Morse code or symbols or, like... It
long short. You say long short, right?
Virgil and I played it pretty well. We got through like the first five stages.
Yeah, but like
we only exploded like,
you know, like a few times. Oh God, this game. I love this game. This is super fun. I can't wait to do more of these. So
yeah, this is amazing.
This seems like a good game that you could set up if you had a session that runs short or someone leaves early. You know, someone's like, I gotta go.
Yeah.
Could just be like, oh, hey, let's bust out some ViewScream real quick.
Exactly.
Yeah, it kind of feels like
last hour out.
Yeah.
I had a group that used to do that with Everyone is John. But
yeah, that's what this game is better than Everyone is John.
Yeah, it's
like,
definitely
every conceivable way. And it does the same time, and it's available online. So this is now directly.
Which isn't
in
to say
my,
that Everyone is John is not good, by the way.
Yeah, that is a good game.
It's a perfectly fine party game.
I mean, it's like saying Mass Effect 2 is better than Mass Effect 1. They're both very good games, but Mass Effect 2 is the greatest.
So, anyways, I'm definitely pocketing this game. You're going to be seeing it a lot more on my channel because this is super fun.
I'm excited for it. And I had a blast.
Yeah, exactly. Like, I also, like, everyone in chat, thank you so much for hanging out. Like, everybody was like, oh my God, this is the greatest. So,
yeah.
I appreciate it. I was looking over, I saw all your guys' stuff. It's super awesome. So, thanks, guys. I love that you guys were loving this. And you were talking about how it was suspenseful a lot. Like, I saw some people in chat mentioning how, like, they actually felt like, oh my God, like, I don't know what to believe. Like, this is.
I didn't know what was going to happen to Sci-Fry the whole time. I was in.
I was like, it was just going around like, is anyone going to help me?
It was really bad because I knew in the first exchange I had to offer him a failure because I wanted to keep my success around. And when he gave me a success, I was like, oh shit. Okay.
Oh shit, you helped me and now I'm going to bone you.
Right. Well, and see,
but then you call me again later and all I had left on my card was a failure and I'm like, oh damn, you're super tough, right?
Like, no.
See, here's the thing. I was keeping track of like successes and failures and stuff. And the fact that he hadn't even gotten to his second emergency yet meant like I realized right away that Sci-Fry was doomed. So
yeah.
I was like, okay, well then I will just optimize things here. I'll make sure that
yeah. You're clearly fucked, so why help you?
Well, yeah, my character also says that medical treats you badly. So
yeah.
When he called and asked for a success, I was like, oh yeah, fuck you. You get a failure.
Yeah.
Perfect. That's the one thing I think I like about this game is that it's very possible for everyone to die, but every scenario is built so at least one person dies.
Yeah.
I love it. So, let's do some outros.
Yeah.
Yeah.
There's a short controlled burst.
Let's start with the MVP.
What's up, guys? I'm Cyfry. You can find me Cyfry with an underscore on Twitter. I believe I'm signed up for your Firebrands game on Friday, Eric. That's going to be awesome.
Yeah.
Gonna play more of that and more mech action going on over there. Tune in for that stream. I have a Twitch, twitch.tv/Cyfry, but I don't use it often. So really just follow me on Twitter. Talk to me about Mobile Suit Gundam.
Yeah, apparently a lot of people reach out to you about it after Firebrands.
Yeah, if you've been curious about Gundam and want to get into it, tweet at me.
Yeah. Super awesome. Wreckage?
Hi, I'm Dr. Wreckage. I do this on a whole bunch of channels and stations and cosmoses. If you'd like to figure out all of the realities and perspectives that I infotain from, please follow me on Twitter at Dr. Wreckage. Not the way it's spelled here. You actually have to spell out the word doctor. The next thing that I will be tweeting out is that we have a game of Fulcrum tonight in 4 hours, where we will be superheroing a thing. We had random generated powers. It's been going on now for months. It's going to be great. There's this big story. There's a big mystery. Everybody loves it. It's a good time. Come join us if you haven't. For superpowers and all that. Doing some secret podcasts with Eric and Cyfry.
Yeah.
And Eric is, Cyfry is going to listen to the podcast after this, isn't he? He's going to tell us whether or not he likes it.
Sure.
Yeah. Then we're going to go, we're going to ship it. Kels is in the Fulcrum show. That's right. You know, then on Sunday, I think maybe if everything happens, or maybe not, because somebody might go to a convention or something. We're supposed to have another episode of Burning Crowns, right? Like, that's going to happen?
Yep.
All right, I'm going to play a game next with week. Arthur.
This week, this Sunday.
Yeah, this Sunday. Hopefully, for sure. I mean,
Sunday. No, we definitely
are. I play a charismatic non-sociopath.
I think the rest of the crew would disagree with some of those words. But tune in. Find out for yourself.
Where you disagree with this play, because it's just that I am a charismatic non-sociopath in real life.
Right.
I hope.
Anyway, thank you so much for joining us. And back to you, Eric.
This is Bridge. Bridge to AP.
Ah, AP here. You can find me on Twitch, Twitter, YouTube, and Facebook, all at AP Gaming Real. I am a tabletop role-playing game streamer. I work with all these people except Cyfry on a regular basis.
Cyfry went and got a job like a loser.
I know.
You can fix that if you want.
Everybody boo Cyfry. Boo. Boo. Boo.
It's dead because of you. It's dead because of you.
Flagship shows. I'm launching 2 new shows next week. On Thursday, I am launching a Shadowrun stream. And on Friday, I'm launching a Mouse Guard stream that's kid-friendly. And tonight would have been Shadowrun, but instead we're playing Saga of the Icelanders. So if you want to see people walking around talking like this, being Vikings, or maybe we're from Norway or something, I don't really know, but check it out tonight.
I buried some fish in the ground.
Wouldn't they
and
be
now
from Iceland?
Put the bark up.
Wouldn't they explicitly be from Iceland?
No.
Well, they're from Norway going to Iceland.
This is the first wave of settlers in 900 AD.
Got it.
So, AP out. Back to you, Eric.
Awesome. Thanks, AP.
I want to play a space Viking in this game.
This was amazing. This is definitely going on my list of games to play this month, along with Firebrands, pretty much for the rest of the month. Let me share a little bit about myself. I'm Eric. I'm a streamer. You probably know me because you're on my channel. If you aren't, welcome. Hello. I do things like GM Burning Crowns, which is a Burning Wheel role-playing game. I GM The Sunless Citadel, which is a Torchbearer role-playing game, or The Oathkeeper's Domain, which is also a Torchbearer role-playing game. I love Burning Wheel HQ games.
So I'm super excited for your game, AP, for Mouseguard. That'd be fun. Let's see, what else? I also do Blades in the Dark on Saturdays. And on Fridays, I do Once Upon a Game, which is a story game one-shot show, which has basically become Firebrands, the show, right now. So Firebrands is super awesome, as Sci-Fi said. Check that out tomorrow at 5 p.m. Pacific if you're not watching AP stuff. So
listen, Eric.
What's up?
Here's my question. Are you a fan of the Resistance?
The
Firebrands. You a Resistance fan?
Wait, what?
The faction.
The faction. No.
Yeah. Are you standing with the Resistance, or are you some cowardly landowning overlord?
He's a filthy offworlder.
He does sound like he's a filthy offworlder, but I'm hoping he's with the Resistance.
No, I'm an offworlder. 100%. Fucking Solar Union.
Fucking Unionist.
Yeah, man. Fucking Space Guilds, dude. Can't beat the Space Guilds, man.
Yes, we can beat the Space Guilds. And we'll do it with our power.
Yeah.
So... yeah, so that's what we do. So super happy to have you guys here. I'm gonna take off a little bit because I'm gonna play some Firebrand Science Story Game Seattle. So that's what I'm gonna do.
Nice.
All right, guys. See you, everybody.